Hello everyone, my name is Gilles Charbonneau and I welcome you to this video on the basics of masking in Anime Studio. In this video, we will have a look at the very basic steps needed to create a mask in Anime Studio. We will watch a complete scene with a mask in it. We will talk about the two basic rules to create a mask in Anime Studio. We will have a look at the construct of a mask in Anime Studio. Then, we will build a mask from scratch inside of Anime Studio. You can download the working files from my blog at the following address. First, let us look at a rendered scene with a mask in it. In this movie, we see a scene with barrels and a skeleton being looked at through an X-ray gun. In this scene, the moving circle with the X-ray version of the scene is the actual mask. Now, before we look at the way this scene is constructed, I will explain the two rules of masking in Anime Studio. Rule number one, in the layers window, all the layers that are part of the mask must be enclosed in either a group or bone layer. Rule number two, in the layers window, the layer that is used as a mask has to reside underneath the layers it is masking. Now that we have laid down the rules, let's have a look at the way the scene is built. At the bottom of our layers window, we have the background image. At the bottom of the group layer, we have our mask, a simple vector circle that will act as the beam for the X-ray gun. At the top of the group layer, we have the X-ray version of the skeleton. This layer is the one being masked and will only show through the mask. Okay, now that we have an idea of how a mask works in Anime Studio, let's build one from scratch inside Anime Studio itself. As mentioned before, at the bottom of the layers window, we have the skeleton background image. The mask will be rendered on top of it. Here we have the mask layer. It is composed of a simple vector circle and will be used to show the layers on top of it. On top of everything, we have the extra skeleton image layer that will be seen through the mask. Now let's create a group layer to actually build the mask. Double-click the new group layer to open its property window and rename it Group Mask. Now we need to drag the layers that will make the mask inside the group layer. Make sure the mask layer is at the bottom of the group layer. Double-click the top layer of the mask and go under the Masking tab to make sure that Mask This Layer is checked. Now we need to make the bottom mask layer a mask by going under the Masking tab and check Add to Mask. We're almost done now, but there is one last thing we need to do to complete the mask. We need to turn on the masking for the group layer by going under the Masking tab for the layer and checking Hide All. We now have a working mask. Hopefully this tutorial was useful to you, and I will see you next time.